Here we are. Welcome to Man of Steel Fan Gives Hope, the Facebook page on YouTube. We're just about to watch Suicide Squad, just at the bit where they're just after the bath scene and they're walking. Press and play. If you haven't watched this before, what we do is you and I, we sit down, we watch Suicide Squad. We're at the bit where Boomerang has just now flung his boomerang. We're having that sort of arcade sort of moment with a wee secret hidden camera that you poke through the door. I don't know, so if you haven't tuned in before, I've done Man of Steel, Batman v Superman Ultimate Edition. If you've got anything you want to say and you want to about any scenes, just put them into the appropriate wee videos. You know, I've done two or three videos before this about Suicide Squad. Maybe it's a scene that you love, or action sequence, or something you may not get. Leave your comments below. Now we're getting up to the bit where Killer Croc, he's about to go on all fours, go into the water. It's always kind of made me sort of weird because, for me, that's kind of dangerous to do, right? Because he's got all that makeup on. Which film one of words for, but he goes on all fours and he crawls into the water, you know, and a sort of ramp, and that's kind of weird because you head down and your fours, it's not like you're diving, you're doing this, it's like you're going crawling deep, so he's got to have an air mask on or a stuntman. So hats off whoever done that scene. Now I've got Katana preparing her soul in case they do meet with the sword. You know, I do videos, as I say. I say this in a lot of the videos before. I try new things. I got a comment before about the music on my phones. I'm just trying to be different. I'm trying new things. What might sound okay on my mobile phone might not sound okay on the device you're using. I apologise. I just don't think I'm I'm entertaining enough. So I like to have a wee bit of music in the background. And hopefully, you know, and try and make each video different. Now, what we're having on Suicide Squad team, you just saw the bullets on the ground. That sort of reminds me of Batman v Superman, where Lex Luthor goes into the building and there's bullets on the ground. And, you know, it's two different directors, but it's quite weird how there's a shot before this where Harley Quinn's walking down the street and it starts off, it shows you the rubble on the road. So it's quite nice that. I used to make videos when I was a kid, so you're sort of trying to figure out how to put where to start your scene. You know, do you start it on somebody's face? Or is it better off just showing you the environment first or the building that you're into first? Now we're just about coming up for the Ghostbusters sort of scene. Again, these are wee moments that you can find in that art game. And what I love about this scene is just the comedy value on this. You got Enchantress' voice in the background, knowing that they're there. And you got Harley Quinn just going, you know, come closer, my child. And then you got Harley Quinn going, yep, okay, dum-de-dum-de-dum. Like nothing's wrong with that. Then you've got her before that saying, you know, do we see the blue light and stuff? I says, oh, must be off my medication. Then you got Will Smith saying, is that your ex? You really need to talk her down and get her to cut off. The true Will Smith moment. And that's probably one of the reasons he got chosen for this role, to deliver those sort of Will Smith lines now. And the touching moment for this is you got the Star Trek moment where it's, and what I mean by the Star Trek moment is Star Trek the Final Frontier, where you have Kirk and this man or whatever, he's trying to take their pain away, their inner pain. So it shows Dr. McCoy, a life where he could have changed things. So, and he goes to Kirk, but Kirk needs his pain. It makes them who they are. So it's no coincidence that Diablo is the one to break this sort of enchantment first. And here we have the Margot Robbie scene with the two kids. Like what I said in before, when you seen the Joker laughing in his hotel room, whatever building he was in, yeah, you seen the baby clothes on the floor. Just please don't give us Joker babies. Same as Superman Returns. I don't want Superman babies. Not interested in babies. Okay, so no more baby talk. So as I say, so Diablo's the first one to come out of the spell because he is no longer that man. He can see this isn't right. He's been living with this guilt for so long. It's made him who he is just now. And he feels better because of it. But if he was to live in a world where his parents, well, with his, sorry, his wife and his kids were still alive, then he could resort back to what he once was. And that's what infuriates him. And that's what how Diablo breaks out the spell first. And why he's the first one to go and confront the witch, because how dare you show me my wife and my kids alive and show me that isn't me? Don't you ever go into my head. And so that's why he's charging forward. I mean, this also, it must be terrifying. I mean, can you imagine, right? So here's a bunch of criminals. They're in the middle of this sort of shopping mall, armed with boomerangs, pink unicorn, don't forget a pink unicorn, and a baseball bat. Of course, yes, I know there's machine guns and guns and a sword, but still, But it goes to show you the bravery. I mean, nobody will ever know what they've done for the world. That's the sad thing about it. And here we have Killer Croc under the water fighting. See that? I didn't notice before. The boomerang, the exploding boomerang. It's funny how you can watch a film so many times and still pick up new wee things. And the cutting off the hand. Don't worry, I have another one. And that sort of goes to show you why he could defeat Diablo, because he drains the power. And now Diablo feels like he can take them on. He's a super powered being there. He can let loose because you're my family. This is my family now. Again, touching moment, bonding with criminals. Even Deadshot's getting. And this is when they're fighting as a team. And he looks in the mirror, Diablo looks in the mirror and sees pictures of kids, reminded again. And now we're coming up to a scene where, let's call it the arm wrestle, where one's getting the better of the other. And it looks like it's going to win, but. Not at the last second. Soldiers and criminals working together, and the sacrifices again. Suicide Squad been made. We have Diablo sacrifice, and we have the soldiers sacrifice. We have just that one moment we think Diablo's going to win, and they're all Yes. But not to be, because again, he's taking the energy. No. Take the bomb, and Rick Flag, being the soldier that he is, finding it hard, even though his first impression of the group was of dislike and resentment, and now he's grown to love the squad he's fighting with. Now we have an Enchantress ready. This is right. I'm just going to use my machine now. My brother is dead. I'm going to use all the information I've got for Amanda and destroy the world and everything else. And then she's going to go to town on him and to show how powerful she is. We have the Ghostbusters moment coming up as they all head off towards the body. It's good that you see the heart or whatever is in there, it's still glowing. So it's like saying, this is my weak spot. This is where you can get me the most. Now we see the global threat. Again, heroes busy doing other things. As I say, it's very hard not to, when you're doing comics, I've said this before, it's very hard to to write comic stories and have Batman fighting somebody he can hardly beat, and then you're wondering, well, why don't you get the assistant of the Flash? No, it's a Batman story. Just like this is a Suicide Squad story. And here we have Enchantress kicking butt and taking names. This is why she's lived for 1,000 years. But instead, of just wiping them out, and because they've fought of a good fight, join me. The aircraft carrier getting destroyed. This in Scotland, the aircraft carriers are getting made, and some people put up claims about, why are we building weapons of mass destruction? It's not destruction, it's a deterrent. It's to have these doesn't mean you're just going to use them. It just means, to have them just means nobody can just get a hold of that red button and press it. There'll be consequences. And I would rather have deterrence rather than not. Same as nuclear weapons. Oh, I like that. The kick in the groin. I feel like eyes are rewinding and slowing down that movement. Well, it's not a groin, it's Harley Quinn getting kicked between the legs. It's very uncommon in film seeing girls getting kicked between the legs. Well, it's the man thing, and then normally it's the woman that's doing it to the man. Kicking the legs. Kick between the legs. I've dead shot. Trying to save his brother, Boomerang. And then we have Killer Croc just showing his strength. Come here, witch, I'll toss you about. Made her run a wee bit. Right, take off your weapons. See, this is why you have somebody rather than Joker. Right, can you see Joker taking on all of them? No. Not unless he takes a pill from the Injustice game, okay? And here we have Harley stepping forward. For a woman that's came from, an Australian soap TV, and I watched a documentary about her, and it's funny how she came from this wee Australian soap, and the people on the set were talking about her, and they said that even though when she was on the set, they knew she was destined for good things. There was something about her. For me, as I say, I talked about acting in the other videos. Clint Eastwood came forward and said, you know, he couldn't act. Samuel Jackson said he's not an actor or whatever. And for me, I think it's the presence of the person. You know, it can be just in the eyes, like Clint Eastwood. With Samuel Jackson, he just has that sort of voice, same as Morgan Freeman. There she goes, takes off the hat, takes out the heart. Now we have the Suicide Squad. Nice wee idea, having them all take part on the saving of the world. Killer Croc's powerful arm throw, Deadshot, oh, Margot Robbie throwing the gun, Deadshot catching. And then we have one last final attempt by the witch with the daughter. And then the daughter, seen with Deadshot, makes his backstory even more important to be in the film. Diablo's backstory more important as well. It's definitely a fun movie. As you watch, you know, as soon as the film starts with the music, as soon as it ends with the graphic designs and stuff like that, it's just fantastic. And here we have the girl playing with her daddy. And it's just in that very last second. It's funny, you know, Will Smith's never had. I don't believe he went to drama school. Okay, I just. Well, maybe he did. I don't know. I don't know. But it's, all I know about Will Smith is he used to be in a wee sort of rap band, and then he went for an audition for the wee comedy series, as we know, as Bel-Air, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. And from there, he got a film role that shot him up. But since then, he's proven by films with Muhammad Ali and. And that one where he loses all the money and everything. The true story of that guy that lost everything, and it was just him and his wee boy. There's Boomerang, he's gonna go for his watch, that's all he's interested in. But then he goes and finds the heart. And again, Boomerang, probably confused why he went for the heart and not for the watch. It's please, yeah, have this. Why did I go for this again? I don't care about this. And here we have the biggest sacrifice that he could make. He could be killing his loved one. Each one of them now standing, they've all got a heart, you know what it's. But again, you start feeling for them, and then it all ends them going back to jail and then being whoever they are again. It's nice that she. She has that sort of Ghostbusters sort of ending as well, when she rips and she takes off all the stuff and she's alive again. Just a lovely, brilliant film. Again, for me, if you took out little wee bits of scenery, you know, and tried to make this a film, that you could, for me, this could have so easily been a good family movie. Again, when it came to the UK, it was a 15. You know, it's been a family film at the weekends. You know, they just had to take out certain wee scenes. Disagree with me or don't agree with me, make your comments below. Or maybe what would be the scenes that you would choose to take out. I'm not saying put in, I'm saying just take out to make it a sort of family friendly film. Or maybe you already know. Well, maybe you already think, because America had a PG-13, maybe you think it was already as a family, but not all countries think that way. Amanda Wallace on. She's still got the power. What do you want? And Captain Boomerang, I'm serving 3 life sentences or something like that. Again, I'm watching it with the volume down. And just buggers that up for himself. And I love, you've got to love the ending, you know, Killer Croc, all he wants is a telly in his room, listen to music, quite like the Justice League cartoons where you see, oh God, what's that gorilla called, kind of white one, very, very smart. He has, like, the cartoon series, he's got a telly and it plays the music, classical music. It's funny watching this now and seeing Will Smith trying to explain to his daughter about hypotenuse, and it's the way he says it. You know, he doesn't come across in this way about angles and hypotenuse and how to come. Actually, I was in school and I was in school and I was getting top maths, and my maths teacher was into comics. Deathstroke, he tried to introduce me to this machine, half machine, half human thing, but it would help teach me through comics and stuff that I would know, you know, not something like two Robins equal you know, but he had that sort of approach to education, and I always remember him for that. And of course he moved on to bigger, he got a job as a headmaster not long after. He was an excellent teacher. So I quite like the fact that Will Smith sitting down there and explaining, you know, this is the best way to kill somebody. And his daughter feeling all that proud. I don't know, I mean, it's very hard to love somebody that you know is a killer, you know. But this is to me is one of the best endings of a film. You know, a real nice, real dirty romantic love story, Harley Quinn, that sipping the nice cup of tea, and no, it's just the music, you know, the music going through, and then the video that Croc's watching is the theme tune to Suicide Squad, and Captain Boomerang's mucked up for himself. No, I just think it's a fantastic ending, and when I watched this in the cinema, I was like being loud and boisterous and saying, right, I do it. There's going to be another scene. There's going to be another scene. Just let's stay here, mate. And then, don't you hate it when you're in the know and you see all these people leaving and you know that there's another scene coming up and you feel like telling them, no, stay. And it's felt the same way for Godzilla. I was like, I was talking and says, I know there's people, I know there's another scene, and the more credits roll up, you're wondering, oh my God, if these people listen to me and I'm talking bull, then it was the very, very last thing that happened. The Godzilla scene, very last thing. Yeah, it's a Joker coming in. I think you get a wee. You sort of know who it is in the just the last second before he takes off the mask. Ah, there it is, Joker. JKR. I love how he comes into Harley and they're all happy to see each other, and then it cuts to a cartoon face, a sort of drawing. And it's all lights, and here we are, we're all at the lights bits. Written and directed by David Ayer. See, it's his baby. It's a Rovan. And as you say, Zack Snyder, Deborah Snyder. So Zack's got, he's got his foot in everything. He's helping it. And I don't care what you say out there, okay? So I read somebody saying, oh, Zack Snyder wanted Batman to do something in that Arkham. It's a lot of bull. I don't want to say it because I don't know what age group is watching this video, but it was really nasty, and I don't think it was ever going to make Batman do that in a film. No, and as I say, in here we're sitting in the cinema and we're watching this. And music was good, entertaining, and as soon as the names come up, you've seen in the background these colourful Joker kind of colours and symbols representing Will Smith, Deadshot, Jared Leto, the cards and the knives, Margot Robbie, the hammer, the baseball bat, the gun, Joel Kinnaman with the machine guns, Viola Davis, the suitcase that had the hat on it. Very, very good, Jack Courtney with the boomerangs. Diablo. So even if you didn't know the real names, the symbols behind the name would have given it away. And it's just, you know, you would leave here seeing this, and you would want another one. You would want another film starting the same sort of way as this. Colourful, bright, artistic. And here we have the moment with Bruce. Then it comes up. Suicide Squad. Warner Brothers Pictures presentation. Susan Backpack doing entertainment. Yep. And all that. An Atlas Entertainment production. Followed by David Ayer. Suicide Squad. And now we're at the extra, the scene. I don't know, maybe, do you think film should have, like, before it comes on, a wee notice saying, please hang back after the film is finished? Should they do that? I don't know. Maybe they like the fact that if people want to go home now, they can, the film's finished. But those that are desperate to see something else, well, we might have a treat. I don't know, what do you think? Do you think we should actually be told there's an extra scene at the end of the film? I don't know. But then again, then you'll think, well, why did they not put it at the end of the film straight away? Because then it'll make that the end of the film. You know, like TV series do, when Flash ends on the TV, the Flash logo comes up, but then it gives you something else, like a wee cliffhanger. Then we have Bruce, you know, Amanda Waller's revealing she knows who Bruce is, and then Bruce Wayne saying, well, listen, if you don't shut this down, my friends and I will. Mainly question, is it this scene, is it this time he's found his friends? So, no, I'm looking forward to whatever comes next. I hope you've enjoyed watching Suicide Squad with us. And I'm so hyped up for Wonder Woman. Again, please, if you like listening to me dribble on, if you like these videos, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a reason to carry on. If you like it, don't like it, or whatever, just leave a comment down below. Next thing I'll be doing, I'll be going to see an art exhibition of the artist Frank Quitely, or whatever his name is. He's done films like All-Star Superman and stuff. So that will be coming on soon, hopefully, weather permitting. So thank you very much for watching it with us. Be positive out there.